how does homeopathy help? Now, the understanding is that homeopathy is based on a nature's law, which is called law of similars. What is law of similars? That what can cause can cure in minute doses. So these patterns that you have, these patterns are not necessarily in the body and the mind, but the what is actually deeply patterned is your energy, is your life force. It's the energy system that is patterned, and it expresses in the mind and it expresses in the body. And this pattern may come from many sources. We don't know from where they come. They can come from generations like her rat fear. They can come from many other places we don't know. You can explain it as past life or whatever. But it's only an explanation. We don't know from where these patterns come. But what happens is that in our homeopathic materia medica, how a homeopathic materia medica is made is very important for you to know as a patient. For example, I'll give you an example. Once I conducted what is called as testing, or it is called proving, okay? Say once I conducted a proving or a testing of a medicine which was made from one drop. Now I'll take her example. One drop, one tiny, tiny drop of rat's blood. One small tiny drop of rat's blood is taken. The animal is not killed, nothing. Just one tiny drop is taken. And it is put in 10 parts of sugar of milk. And it is triturated in a particular way. Okay? From that, one part is taken and put in another 10 parts of sugar of milk and triturated. Then from that, one more part is taken, again triturated, okay, and then from that it is dissolved in alcohol or water, and then from one drop of that it is another 100 drops of alcohol or water are added and jerked. From that again one drop is taken in 100 parts or drops of water and jerked. Now this would become kind of, by now whatever I spoke became 5 potency. Okay, most often the potency that you will get will be surely more than 30. You will get 30 200 1000 10000. You can imagine how much it is diluted. Okay, so by that time that substance is not there in the medicine, only the energy of the medicine is there. In that aspect, there is no homeopathic medicine which is non-vegetarian, because there is no actually substance in it. It's only the pattern that is there. And once a medicine is made, it will last for all homeopaths forever. You don't need to kill animals for that. What I made from one drop of rat's blood will be available to the whole world homeopaths forever, because there will be constant dilution process. Are you there? All I have to do is dilute, jerk and give it. So the medicine which I have made is available in all pharmacy, homeopathic pharmacies in the world. As it becomes weaker, it becomes more stronger. Every time you dilute it and you jerk it, it becomes stronger. Okay? So in that way, homeopathy is opposite of allopathy. There the dose is powerful if more substance is there in it. Here the dose is powerful if less substance is there in it. Can you see the difference? Okay, now the second is, I'll give you an example that when we did the rat testing, we had a group of 20 people. They did not know what they were getting. They got the rat dilution in 200 potency. Means there is no rat's blood in it by that time. There is a figure called Avogadro's number in physics. Beyond that number in the dilution, there is no substance. Okay, so these dilutions are far beyond. So they cannot cause any chemical side effects. Okay. So when we did, 20 people were given one powder of the rat's blood. Okay, and there were 10 supervisors And these supervisors did not know what was given to these 10 people. Two people were to report to one supervisor. Supervisor does not know what was given. Are you there? And for 1 month, they keep on reporting what changes are occurring in their mind and body. After 1 month, everybody meets together and discusses jointly what was happening to them. And all this is systematically recorded. There is a specific scientific way in which the supervisor is supposed to record what is happening. Now this becomes a record of testing of rat's blood. Okay? For example, many of the brewers or testers started telling lies. Many testers started stealing. Many testers became extremely sexy. They wanted to wear very jazzy shirts and pants. They were feeling very joyous. They were very laughing, talking. Are you there? Two provers got cutting pains in the clavicle. The stomach felt as if it was torn apart. So in all parts of the body and mind, all these testing symptoms are recorded. One prover went to the mirror and was looking at the mirror for 1 hour trying to trim his moustache, and he felt irresistible desire to do this. And they had particular color choices. And many of them dreamt that they were pursued and they were going to be killed. So the proving statement runs in 200 pages. Okay. Now, when I get a client, for example, I had one client who she said that her main problem in her life was she can't stop lying. She says, I don't know why I say lies. And she quoted to me so many situations where there was no need to tell lies, but she had compulsion to tell lies. And then she had dreams which are exactly like this brewer's dreams. And she had this ugly feeling which was also like this brewer. And then she had a lot of sexual feelings. Many aspects were like this testing. Are you there? But she had come to me with PCOD and no menses for 3 years. She had male pattern, hair growing and all this. Now this woman got one dose made from this rat's energy, and the moment she got that, in 3 months her menstrual cycles became normal, her relationships changed, her habit of lying went away, her fears and dreams changed, everything changed in her life. So what the law is based on is called like cures like. It's the law of similars. So when two disturbances which are very similar meet in your life force, then one heals the other. Like if two dissimilar diseases meet in your body, say for example, you have constipation, okay? You have constipation and you take Dulcolax, milk of magnesia, whatever. You take drugs to purge your self out. Now what will happen when you take that drug? What will be the primary effect? What does the body recognize it as? Body will recognize this as a foreign substance. Are you there or not? So what will that foreign substance cause? The first reaction will be the body will cause a diarrhea as a pathological chemical effect of what you are taking, right? But after some time, now the body will react to this. How will the body react to something that is causing diarrhea? Supposing, what is body's natural way? If I am having diarrhea, the body will cause more diarrhea. What will it cause? Constipation. So after the effect of that milk of magnesia is over, you will become more constipated because the body sees this as a bacteria or something foreign come into the body. So it reacts opposite. So it will cause more constipation. Then you will need more amount of doses to. Pehle ek milk of magnesia se ho jati thi, abhi do lena padta hai. Baad mein aste aste it becomes kayam. That's why they put kayam churna. Means once you are into that, you will be kayam. And kayam it will keep on increasing. That's how they make. You will get addicted to it and you will need larger and larger doses because the body is all the time confused. And it is constantly producing constipation because the body thinks that this diarrhea is a disease and it produces constipation. Whereas what a homeopath will give you, that he'll give you, say, for example, in our Materia Medica, there is one substance called alumina, and it causes very hard constipation. When the Pruvas took it, they felt that they became very constipated, hard stools, right? So we give one dose of alumina, the body reacts to constipation, then it produces a normal stool. It stimulates your life force in a right way. A contrary stimuli produces a secondary reaction which is opposite and which causes more disease. That's why you will need more drugs. Never it happens that your doses of thyroid reduce. Never it happens that your doses of blood pressure medicine reduce. They always keep increasing. Your diabetes doses, they always keep increasing, no? Till one point, now nothing works. Or only partially works. But when you work on yourself with other methods, then you have chances of reducing the doses. Because now the body is learning how to deal with it. So again, answering Harsh's question is that homeopathy treats your system. It doesn't treat your symptoms, your disease label. Okay. What was the other question was that yes, homeopathy can be very fast. In acute situations, we have seen homeopathy works very fast. And it also works in wide range of diseases which are chronic. Even in cancer cases, we have seen many cases respond. There is no side effect because all this is very material dose, and there is a way in which that testing is ended. It's a volunteers, it is done under very close supervision. And then there are rules laid down, we have specific ways how we end that testing. So that testing ends with an antidote or whatever, you know, there is a way, there is a scientific way that is laid down. Okay? There is no side effect, there is no side effect. And this testing is done on volunteers. They have volunteered to do this.